thank you for taking me as part of this project.
You grew up in Italy. How was it to grow up there, and how did you end up here?
So I'm half Italian, half Finnish. So my mother is from Finland. She's actually here from Helsinki. My childhood in Italy was also quite interesting, because I was also moving there. I was living in three different places there as well. So I actually started, I lived in an area in the Veneto region, just close to Venice, in the city of Padova. I was living there at first when I was born. And then we moved to the Dolomite area, so just on the border to Austria. So actually I went there, I went to German schools there for some years.
Oh.
First I started with Italian schools, Italian language schools, then I started with German schools for some years, and then we moved to Finland, and the rest was, well, in Finnish. And it was a horrible cultural shock, actually, to move up here. Because I remember the first winter I moved to Finland, it was... Even though I was always visiting my grandparents every summer, but it was the first winter I experienced when I moved here, and it was minus 30 degrees. It was like the coldest winter in years, and it was just absolutely horrible.
Oh my God.
So yeah, at first it was horrible. But then, I don't know, nowadays I would definitely identify as a local person here in Helsinki. My mother is from Helsinki as well. She's from the Vanha Kaupunki Arabia areas.
So how did you end up in Kallio?
Well, everyone that has good taste ends up at some point in Kallio, I believe. I don't know, I was living actually, this is the third place where I'm living now here in Kallio. I don't know, first of my, most of my friends were living here, and also the night life was here at the time. I believe those were some reasons I actually moved here at first. But also because it's definitely more colorful. It's more colorful than any other area in Helsinki, and I kind of feel, you know, this, you have this different vibe, you know, it's more like a Mediterranean area sometimes. You could kind of imagine that you're not in Finland, because it's so, you know, alive, and not everything is always alive in Finland, especially during the winter season. So I believe, yeah, those were kind of the reasons at first why I decided to move here.
You're a tourist guide.
I am, as well. Yes,
yes. And what's as well?
I'm also working with wine. I actually do drink professionally.
Ah, wow.
It's a great job.
Yes.
So I do arrange wine tastings, but then I would say maybe because I also do food tours in Helsinki.
Yeah.
So everything goes back to, you know, culinarism at the end, you know, wine and food and those things. And obviously I'm Italian, so it's something, you know, in my DNA, food and wines and all these things. But I do also arrange walking tours of Helsinki as well. And I do specialize a little bit maybe in the areas which are on the northern part of our Pitkäsilta, so
yes,
the long bridge, so the symbol in the past between the different social classes, I would say, that the areas which are more to the northern part of our long bridge, so Pitkäsilta.
But what inspires you in your work?
In my work? Well, I have been working with tourism actually pretty much all my life, more or less. Well, I also tried other things in between. I studied music as well, and many other things. But at the end, I don't know, tourism somehow, and showing the city of Helsinki, for example, I don't know, it's I really like this city, not only Kallio area, even though Kallio obviously is very close to my heart because I also live here, but Helsinki in general, I would say, is I think it's a beautiful city, and I really like to talk about it and show around, and I do it with my heart. So it's like, I guess that's how I got to do that.
Do you organize tours for locals? I want to.
I do a lot actually, especially because of the COVID season. You know, that when people couldn't travel, you know, I actually started to work more with Finnish companies and associations. And so definitely I arrange a lot of tours for Finnish people as well. in Kallio, for example. Yes.
So, but what's your special? What do you specially like? Special places, or what do you like in Kallio?
In Kallio, you know, the food scene in general. Lots of nice restaurants and bars where you can go and enjoy your life. And I have a great coffee shop also next to my home where they make their own bread, and you feel like you are in some Italian coffee shop. And
what's,
you know,
the name of that place?
Meli. Yeah,
ah.
On Helsingin katu.
Well, oh yeah, yeah, and yes.
It's already in the Harju area, but you know, kind of, we can talk.
That's kind of Kallio.
Yeah.
Anyway.
I would say, and then cultural events, especially before COVID. Now, you know, it's getting slowly back to it as well. And then what I really like is that it's so. If you walk, for example, from Hakaniemi to Helsingin katu, you have many different areas on the way, and it changes a lot, you know, the surroundings. You have Torkkelinmäki, which is like totally different than, for example, I don't know, well, if we talk about Hakaniemi area, Merihaka, for example, and you know, it's just, I don't know, it's just very different from one place to the other. I wouldn't say there is nature around here so much, even though I love nature, but close to Kallio, there are lots of nice places where you can also enjoy nature. So I would say that's also kind of a plus, that it's very easy for you to get to kind of, you know, parks and,
yes,
and woods, and, you know, to enjoy kind of, you know, the greens as well.
That sounds, I want to come to your guided tour of Helsinki. That sounds so interesting.
Thank you.
Hey, thank you for agreeing to be interviewed. These are just the short stories.
Mm-hmm.
But who would you like me to interview next, and why?
So when you asked me this question, I had one person on my mind straight away. I was thinking about who could be like very interesting and in a maybe in a slightly positive way, also strange, like I am as well, slightly maybe. So Jukka Marttinen, who is a friend of mine, I've been knowing him for years, and he's kind of a colorful person. So that's why I kind of, it was, the instinct was to kind of give his name, because I thought that he would be quite right for this kind of interview.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.